In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Saturday, the 16th of September, 2023. 23rd week in ordinary time, and today we keep the memorial of Saints Cornelius, Pope, and Cyprian, Bishop Martyrs. Cornelius was made Bishop of the Church in Rome in the year 251. He fought against the Novatian schismatics and established his authority with the aid of Cyprian. The Emperor Gallus sent him into exile, and he died at Civitavecchia in Italy in June 253. He is buried in Rome. Cyprian, 210 to 258. He was born in Carthage and spent most of his life in the practice of the law. He was converted to Christianity and was made Bishop of Carthage in 249. He steered the church through troubled times, including the persecution of the Emperor Decius, when he went into hiding so as to be able to continue looking after the church. In 258, the persecution of the Emperor Valerian began. Cyprian was first exiled and then on the 14th of September, executed after a trial notable for the calm and courtesy shown by both sides. Cyprian's many letters and treatises shed much light on a formative period in the church's history and are valuable both for their doctrine and for the picture they paint of a group of people in constant peril of their lives, but still determined to keep the faith. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Belinda Assam, celebrating her birthday today from Douala, Cameroon, texts for us the first reading. Innocent Miti, celebrating his birthday today from Lusaka, Zambia, texts for us the responsorio psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Felix Ainomugisha Amoti, celebrating his birthday today from Fort Portal Diocese in Uganda. Let us pray. O God, who gave Saints Cornelius and Cyprian to your people as diligent shepherds and valiant martyrs, grant that through their intercession we may be strengthened in faith and constancy and spend ourselves without reserve for the unity of the Church. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. He came into the world to save sinners. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy, 1 Timothy chapter 1, verses 15 to 17. Beloved, the saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. And I am the foremost of sinners. But I received mercy for this reason, that in me, as the foremost, Jesus Christ might display his perfect patience for an example to those who were to believe in him for eternal life. To the King of ages, immortal, invisible, the only God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm 113 verses 1 to 2, 3 to 4, 5a and 6 to 7. The response is taken from Psalm 113 verses 2. And the response is, may the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore.
May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore.
Praise, O servant of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. May the name of the Lord be blessed both now and forevermore.
May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore.
From the rising of the sun to its setting, praise be the name of the Lord. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens, his glory.
May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore.
Who is like the Lord, our God, who lowers himself to look down upon heaven and earth? From the dust he lifts up the lowly, from the ash heap he raises the poor.
May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore.
Gospel Acclamation, John 14:23.
Hallelujah, my Savior Jesus. Hallelujah, my Savior Jesus. Hallelujah, my Savior Jesus. Hallelujah, my Savior Jesus.
If a man loves me, he will keep my word, says the Lord, and my Father will love him and will come to him.
Hallelujah, my Savior Jesus. Hallelujah, my Savior Jesus. Hallelujah, my Savior Jesus. Hallelujah, my Savior Jesus.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 6, verses 43 to 49.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, no good tree bears bad fruit, nor again does a bad tree bear good fruit. For each tree is known by its own fruit. For figs are not gathered from thorns, nor are grapes picked from bramble bush. The good man out of the good treasure of his heart produces good. And the evil man, out of his evil treasure, produces evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and not do what I tell you? Everyone who comes to me and hears my words and does them, I will show you what he is like. He is like a man building a house who dug deep and laid the foundation upon the rock, and when a flood arose, the stream broke against that house and could not shake it, because it had been well built. But he who hears and does not do them is like a man who built a house on the ground without a foundation, against which the stream broke, and immediately it fell, and the rain of that house was great. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
From yesterday until Saturday next week, we are looking at the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Yesterday, I didn't comment about this letter, though we took that as the first reading. Our focus was on Our Lady of Sorrows, and I focused on that, focusing on the gospel passage that we read yesterday. And today, I want to give a brief background of this letter. Now, if you look at the nature of this letter, it is pastoral. It is a pastoral letter because it is dealing with the role a pastor plays in the community of believers. And it is ascribed to Paul to say he's the one who wrote it, but wait a minute. He might have written it, and if he wrote it, He might have written it around 63 to 67 AD. But in the actual fact, many scholars have agreed that this letter might have been written by one of the disciples of St. Paul who had understood the theology of St. Paul. Therefore, this letter might have been written towards the end of the first century AD. We are talking of between 80 to 90 or 90 to 100, somewhere there. It is having the language of Paul, I want you to understand, and we are going to refer to this letter as the letter of St. Paul to Timothy. I am not ruling out that, and we are keeping it that way. One thing we have to understand is that as he writes to Timothy, he gives himself as an example. He wants to say, as pastors, we are supposed to lead by example. And when I am preaching, let it also connect to my own life. Otherwise, it will be empty talk. St. Paul, in writing to Timothy, makes it clear that the message that he is giving to Timothy is the message of the mercy of God, the God who showed his mercy on the cross, and he showed it to sinners. And he says, I am an example of the sinner who was shown mercy by God. And I am not giving a platonic speech. I am not giving you something that has nothing to do with reality. No, I'm preaching to you what I have experienced myself. Oh, how nice would that be? That as parents, wherever we are, because as parents, we are also pastors. We are pasturing our own children. We are shepherding our own children. And so as shepherds of our own children, when we are talking to them, they want to hear something that we have experienced ourselves and how we overcame anything and everything that we experienced in order to be where we are. It can be even a bad experience. Look at Paul. He's not afraid, he's not ashamed to talk about how Jesus took him out of his sinfulness. He has narrated many times about the way he was moving towards the destruction of the church, but he came out as a true constructor of the church. I don't know what you can share as your own example to your children, how God took you out of your situation and how, despite the fact that you have been a drunkard, you managed to come out of your drunkenness so that your children can also listen to that and say, if I find myself in a drunken state, I will know how to come out because my dad came out of it. There is no way you are going to tell your children about being drunkards and stopping to drink when you are still a drunkard yourself. Get out of it and then help the children with your reformed character. That's what Paul is telling Timothy. And I am the foremost of sinners, but I received mercy for this reason, that in me, as the foremost, Jesus Christ might display his perfect patience for an example to those who were to believe in him for eternal life. That mercy was not wasted that he received, nor he changed for the better. And he's saying, you can also change for the better. You can also boast about the mercy you have received because you have taken advantage of that mercy and become a better person in your life. That's what is important. And we can draw the transforming inspirations from the gospel passage of today, which is a collection of sayings in the Gospel of St. Luke. St. Luke puts together a collection of sayings of Jesus and puts that collection in the context of the Sermon on the Plain. Here he's talking about what can come out of us. He's training thoughts. He wants to say that the good person out of the good treasure of his heart produces good, and the evil person out of his evil treasure produces evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks. You can know what a person has in his heart from what is spoken. Ask someone to stand and share a word of encouragement, and you will see what will come out of that person. It will come out from what a person has been entertaining. And you can see the conviction with which a person speaks. That's why I don't agree with those people who say that that man's dressing is tempting me. That woman's dressing has caused all the trouble in me. No, it is what you put in your head. It is what you put in your thinking that interprets everything wrongly. And I don't like this blame game that is found in men from the beginning of creation. It is the woman you gave me, says Adam. And that has never stopped. We go to church. We come back and we say, I was distracted. By who? By the way that woman was dressing. But if it is your sister dressing the same way, it won't affect you. Why? Because that is what is in your head. You entertain those thoughts. And we want to say, Lord, help us to rework on our thoughts. Let our religion help us to clean our thinking, our hearts. So that we may be pure in the way we look at other people and not just see them as objects, but as brothers and sisters in the kingdom of our God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Saturday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. You're there. Spoken to me, and I this is the